Can we knock at the door and hand it in now? Because that's why we're here.
They might have gone away.
Yes.
Might have left. Yes.
Keep back, madam. So we can see. Fine. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Teddy Woodward, I gather that you're rather concerned about a lot of theatres in the Covent Garden area, for one thing. Could you tell me which those are and why you're concerned for the future?
There's approximately 17 altogether. It's not just the Covent Garden area, and we're not here really today purely, it's a Save the Theatre campaign. Save the Theatres campaign is the main object. But in fact, it's a much broader issue than that. It's to save London. I mean, London is disappearing. Fast. Now, a six-lane highway going up Charing Cross Road will destroy a number of theatres, it will destroy an enormous number of livelihoods, and it will destroy basically the reason that people come to London. I mean, many surveys have been done. They come to London to see the Tower, Buckingham Palace, and they go to the theatre.
And there's no new lease being offered to the management that control those theatres. So many theatres can be pulled down, not just because of road widening, but because of probably speculation and also general GLC plans in the Covent Garden area.
They built, you know, great modern theatres, I mean, as there are a few examples at the moment. This is losing a lot of charm of London theatre. I mean, the sort of oldness of some of the theatres is the sort of great charm of them.
It isn't that some theatres may be pulled down, it's that they will be unable to operate because of increased noise from traffic. And also, the whole situation round the theatres, where there are shops and firms which serve the theatre, will probably be turned into offices, and theatre land, as we call it and is known, will cease to exist.
Not only that, I mean, the thing with all these redevelopment schemes is that they say they may or they may not. I think what you've got to do is what we're doing is get in quickly until they say we're going to. Because at the moment, they're leaving it like that, so that we may... I mean, like the Criterion, a classic example, I don't know if anybody's told you, but they said the Criterion had been saved, and we all said, whoopee, the Criterion has been saved. We now discover that their way of saving the Criterion is to knock down the back of it, which is all the dressing rooms. So all we're going to be left with is a stage and a front of house.
And absolutely nowhere to change.
Nowhere to change, nowhere to come in. So presumably, we'll change with the audience, get up on the stage and do the performance and go out through the audience. You know, I mean, that's the sort of thing that might happen.
And Mr. Rippon has said that the buildings of historic interest in the Covent Garden area are going to be preserved. Do you not believe him?
No, frankly, I don't. We've heard this so often, haven't we? I mean, honestly, all over the country. I really don't trust development people at all, because it seems to me that development is done for two reasons: to make more room for motor cars and to make more money for property developers. And that seems to be the main motive for the redevelopment of London. It doesn't seem to be anything to do with the life of London or what visitors come to London to see. And I don't only apply this to London, I apply it to an awful lot of towns. I mean, where are we going to live? Where are we going to meet? Where are we going to go to restaurants? Where are we going to walk about the streets without being choked by fumes? That seems to me the important thing. I mean, it's not just a selfish thing for actors.